Harold was a dedicated public servant who had strong convictions and pursued them with vigor and courage. He worked toward eliminating the firewalls between the various communities, ethnic communities. And although it's still there, there's a lot more movement among various ethnic groups.
We have learned one thing in this generation in Chicago. It is that bossism is not leadership, and leadership is not bossism.
He was just open, inquisitive, and creative. But he knew who he was. He's the most skilled political leader I've ever dealt with. Barack Obama would have a hard time being on sheer smarter than Harold. And but then, in understanding processes and how people are motivated, express themselves, and organize, it's street smart. Harold is far, far ahead of Obama.
I would describe him as charismatic, very competent. He was the man for that moment, 1980s. He came at the end of a long struggle for African-American rights in Chicago, starting in the 50s and coming through the 60s and sort of culminating with his election in 1983-84.
Some members of my cabinet will be required to take salaries considerably less than their counterparts are now making. So that there is no confusion, these cuts will begin in the mayor's office.
Harold Washington believed very strongly in fairness and in equity and justice for all. Now that sounds like something very trite, but it was true when it came to him.
When you think about it, really, this audience is what Chicago's all about. I look out there, right. I look out there at 3,000 people, you know what I see? I see 3 million people in Chicago coming together in unison.
The experience of working with his administration changed me. And I'd been in politics for 35 years. Gave me a sense of how practically you have to both bring people in and be very skilled at building alliances or isolating your enemies.
Council wars stymied the first 3 years of Washington's first term, with the majority of the city's aldermen opposing his programs, often just because they were his. The council had broken clearly along racial lines.
The president recognizes Alderman Terrace.
I move we adjourn.
You heard the motion. All in favor, signify by saying aye. Opposed, no. Council is adjourned.
I would like to tell all of you that we want Harold here too, but he ran away.
Mr. President, may we proceed with the business of this city council?
He wanted to make the government open. And so the budget before Harold was a secret document like the papal encyclical that only a few people knew about. And so now it's a whole open budget process. Of course, Rahm Emanuel's trying to move it back to a more closed process.
He started the 35% requirement on the part of city contracts being given to African Americans and Hispanics. And of course that number, after he passed, went down.
The issue is, shall we have a new system in which people are involved in their city, or we're gonna have the old system in which special interests run it to the detriment of the city and for their benefit. That's the issue. There is no other issue.
We see, however, at least the pretense of trying to live up to what he put in place, because he, for instance, put in place the Open Meetings Act. He put in place access on the part of citizens to all kinds of documents that were generated by the city.
I wasn't groomed for mayor. I was assistant corporation counsel. I was a secretary to an alderman. I was a state senator. I was a state representative. I was a congressman. I came up through the machine, broke and went independent. I've been dealing with budgets and appropriations and personnel and Department of Affairs all my life.
I think Harold Washington just became such a tremendous symbol for the city of Chicago, not only because he became mayor, but because he fought the good fight.
For as much as the spirit of Harold Washington has returned unto God who gave it, we therefore commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
Since he was only able to be in office for 4.5 years, he was not able to make many institutional changes in the government. And so there's been a step back from it. But it took Richie Daley 10 years before he gave up Harold's slogans like Chicago Works Together.
Whereas there has been an increase in the number of black elected officials, I don't think that those officials are as aggressive in their pushing of black ideas and black interests as they were during the Harold Washington administration.
On Bay Street, that Bay Street, I just want to...
Well, he enjoyed representing Chicago. He said, I want to make sure we change the image of Chicago, not as a gangster town, but as a town of diversity and a town of progressive people.